Hey everyone, this is Terri with Travel Talk with Terri, and today's question comes from Leslie. She wanted to know if I had any travel photography tips. When I first got this question, I'm like, this is a good one because it's the beginning of the year and people are planning their travels and everybody wants to capture them and we're doing it with photos. On the other hand, it's a very complex question because to get great photos, you really do have to practice, and you really have to, study it to really get good. And I'll tell you, I've taken many workshops. I still continue to take many workshops. I practice, and I basically hate 75% of the photos I take. So that's kind of like my disclaimer, but I think that there are some basic tips I can tell you that I can share with you that will give you a sense of place and that you can take back home and have great memories of your vacation. So first let me share with you what I shoot with, which kind of leads into the first overall travel tip. This is what I shoot with. This is my basic beginner DSLR. It's Nikon. I love it. It's not full frame. It's not professional. It came with a kit, lens, and the body, less than $700 when my husband bought it 5 years ago. Maybe it was 4 years ago. Yeah, it was 4 years ago. Since then, I've purchased a couple of lenses that will be interchangeable should I decide to upgrade, which I think that I will. But what I want to tell you is buying a camera like this is not going to make your photos more gorgeous and more fabulous. All it's going to do is have you lugging around a camera that's going to weigh down your backpack and your purse. Because unless you're prepared to spend the time and energy into learning all the functions of that camera and not keeping it on auto mode, you're really not going to see any different in your photos. For me, I use a combination of this camera here and my Samsung Galaxy S4, which is my camera phone that I can't show you because I'm videotaping with it right now. But sometimes I don't want to look like a tourist. I just want to have my regular, just my camera phone, because it does take great photos. Where I'm going with this is that you don't need a bigger camera. You don't need a huge DSLR. A point and shoot will get you great photos, because really it boils down to, it's not the wand, it's the magician. The magician has to make the magic happen. And the magician is you. So let me start. Wrote my notes down because I didn't want to forget. But overall, you want to think people, places, and things. You want to take photos of people, things that accentuate the place, that show how it's different from where you come from, and the things that represent that that place. People, places, and things. If you keep that in mind, you're already starting out ahead. The next thing you want to do is get as close as possible to what you're taking a photo of. And that means not zooming in. That means physically moving closer, because that will give you a better image on the output. The next thing you want to do is capture the details. And when you capture the details, what I mean is, you want to not just get the, for example, a full shot of the cathedral, but then focus on the windows, focus on the pews or the pillars inside of the cathedral. This is capturing details along with the wider picture of the inside or the exterior of this building. So for example, you can use, think wide, medium, tight, right? You get the wide shot, which will have the entire, I'm going to use a cathedral for example, the entire building. Then the next picture may narrow that down somewhere. You might, it fills the frame and it's a little bit tighter. And then the next thing might be a picture of the door handles or something like that. I mean, I'm just throwing these out there, but I kind of want you to get a visual of what I mean when I say capturing the details. And I mentioned fill the frame. Let me tell you what I mean by fill the frame. Let's say this is the frame. If you're taking a picture of a cathedral, make sure that thing fills as much as you can of your frame and you don't have a bunch of superfluous stuff around that object. that doesn't relate to the photo. That's called filling the frame. And filling the frame will also help you capture all of the details. One of my favorite that I know you're really not going to feel, I mean, I don't know this, but I think that this is true because I don't see a lot of tourists out when I'm up first thing in the morning, and that's what I'm going to tell you. Beat the rush. If you are exploring a small historic town and you want to really capture it, beat the rush and get out there when the sun's coming up. That means set your clock. And when the sun's coming up, you should be walking out the door of your hotel or apartment and capture the city that way. The lighting is great. You won't have a bunch of tourists and with their backpacks and their fanny packs and their cameras all up in your shots. And not that that isn't good sometimes, because sometimes you want to capture the people, but you want to capture the people that are locals. You don't want to capture a bunch of tourists taking pictures. You don't want that to be the main focus, I don't think. And if you want to get photos, like I said, of architecture and, you know, just great wide shots of a city, get up in the morning while that lighting is great and while everybody else is sleeping and take your photos. Yeah, that's my tip. So I'm going to tell you, think people, places, things, get closer, fill the frame, get the details, and wake up in the morning so you can get that great lighting. After this video, I got a picture of photos, some samples that kind of illustrate these tips that I've given you. In the meantime, if you want to get better, you got to practice, practice, practice to make it perfect. Happy travels, and till next time, peace.